People use proxies in business all the time to get valuable data and automate processes. In this video, we'll show you how to use proxies in business and what you should know before you start. We'll answer the common questions that we get asked here at Proxyway. You're welcome to send us your question too. You can do that by commenting below our YouTube videos or at proxyway.com. See an interesting question? Use timestamps in the description below to skip to the part of the video that is relevant to you. So, the first question is, what is a proxy-powered solution? Proxy-powered solutions are any data scraping, price monitoring, competitor analysis, or any other tools and services that are based on the usage of proxies. Number two, why do large enterprises and small businesses use proxy-powered solutions? Well, proxy-powered solutions provide data which you can turn into insights. This is valuable. Enterprises use proxies for business intelligence. For example, to look at competitor price movements, product offerings, or search engine positions. Other use cases would be brand protection to search for infringing content, localizing marketing campaigns, and so on. Providers have recently been pushing alternative data, such as looking at Reddit to make financial decisions, and cybersecurity, like email protection, as viable uses. If you're interested to learn more about ways to use proxies for your business, we have a written blog post describing each use case in more detail. You can find the link in the video description below. Number three, do businesses perform data scraping in-house or by contracting service providers? It depends on multiple factors. For example, how big the scope is, and if the company has the resources to maintain their own infrastructure. The more data you need to collect, the bigger the incentive you have to build things in-house. This gives you more control and makes sense financially. Proxies are basically a raw tool. They're the most resource-intensive option, but also the cheapest straight on. Things like search engine APIs offload some of the work from you, but they can cost more. Data collection services are the easiest but costliest option. Number four, data is a valuable asset for enterprises, especially for the enterprises that are already involved with data scraping. So what prevents them from performing even more data scraping? If we're talking about proxies, it's labor and maintenance costs. Web scraping at scale by yourself is hard, and it requires a lot of effort to maintain. Proxy pools have downtime, and they fluctuate if you're using residential IPs, and sometimes get banned out. And this is only one part of web scraping. Companies go a long way to hide their use of proxies. It's a taboo topic, as we found out last year, due to all the negative associations involved. So sometimes it's hard to say if and to what extent they're using proxy-powered solutions. Then there's the matter of actually making use of the data you've collected. Surprisingly, quite a few companies find that a challenge. Number five, how much do enterprises spend on proxy-powered solutions? Well, that really depends. Enterprises strike individual deals with providers which are hard to approximate. Contract length, scope, and other factors come into play. And six, what is the public perception of using proxies? Proxies are still a no-no, despite best efforts by companies like Bright Data and Oxylabs. Too many bad associations. Last year, we couldn't get some content published on well-known brands because they shield away from associations with proxy networks. Maybe this will change, at the cost of more intrusive user profiling. Proxy providers are now starting to educate about ethical residential proxy acquisition models. Or maybe they will be moving to a less sensitive type of proxies altogether. Static residential proxies? Maybe, maybe not. And number seven, how do you think data usage by enterprises will be approached in the future in regards to regulation and laws? Well, public data is generally good to go, as long as it avoids privately identifiable information. But we're no lawyers, so don't take our word for it. Companies like Zeit are already including legal review as part of their data collection services, so I think there's nothing holding enterprises from doing the same internally. Like this video? Subscribe to our channel for weekly videos about proxies, and watch this next month. See you there.